Alhamdulillah.
Alhamdulillah.
Terima kasih kepada semua kawan-kawan kita yang terus dengan kita daripada pukul 6 tadi sampai sekarang ni. Dan sempena musim haji ni, pagi ni kita bersama dengan Ahmad Falatah, berasal dari Arab Saudi dan dah tinggal di Malaysia 12 tahun. Dan dah 5 kali buat haji.
Banyak lah. Banyak dia nak share experience dengan kita ni. Dia kata ada satu benda yang tough sewaktu di Arafah dan Mina.
Yes.
Tapi tak boleh lagi.
Itu sekejap lagi sambung. Tapi sekarang ni, Ahmad.
Yes.
Saya nak bawa awak masuk ke dalam.
Ke dalam mana? Ke dalam komputer.
Mawi Jawi. So kita dalam Mawi Jawi ni kita akan belajar mengeja dalam Jawi.
You know Jawi? Ahmad?
Jawi is language. Arabic, right?
It's not language. It's just the letters.
The letters, yes. Yeah, the Malaysian, the alphabets, the Arabic alphabets. Right?
Yes.
Okay.
So kita nak eja apa? Kita eja ni lah. Tak payah bagi dia perkataan Melayu lah. Kita bagi haji in Hajj. In English,
what
pilgrimage?
Pilgrimage.
Yeah. Okay, pilgrimage. To agent in Jawi, the pilgrimage.
Pilgrimage.
You know,
pilgrimage.
Yes.
Pilgrimage.
Pilgrimage.
Yes.
Try now.
Hajj.
No, pilgrimage. Spell it in Jawi.
Hajj.
Pilgrimage.
Hajim. Hajj.
No, you spell the word pilgrimage.
Okay.
In Jawi.
Pilgrimage.
P-I-L-A. I think this one Mari need to teach you.
Pilgrimage in Jawi. Ba.
Okay.
Ba.
Lam.
Ba lam.
Jim.
Jim.
Ra.
Ra.
Mim.
Mim.
Jim.
Jim.
Correct.
Okay lah tu. Good try, mate.
Okay. Okay.
Okay. Kita cek ni ikut Mawi Jawi Balam Jim Ro Mim Jim. Bunyi dia Belger Merge.
The sound.
You should put it together. You have to put it one word.
Belger Merge. Tapi dalam ikut Mawi Jawi Pilgrimage. Betul?
Pilgrimage.
Pa.
Pa.
Ya.
Ya.
Lam.
Pil.
Pil.
We have our own alphabet. Pa.
Pa.
Oh,
Pa. Ini boleh, Ga.
We have ga.
Ro. Ya.
Mim.
Mim. Ya. Jim.
Pilgrimage. So the sound is better, isn't it?
Pilgrimage.
Sound more authentic.
Apa-apa pun kita kena rujuk.
Fun juga kan. Fun tu fun juga. Tapi ada benda yang paling mencabar lah. The toughest.
See, the toughest to me, because I experienced Hajj like back in 2019 something.
Early 2000.
So during the time, like, you know, it wasn't systematic as same as now.
Okay.
Like, everything is organized. So during the time, you know, sometimes you sleep at the roadside. You want to feel the ibadah. Sometimes, like, you want to walk from Muzdalifah to meet from Arafah to Muzdalifah. But the toughest I really experienced, I went on my own with my cousin, and was in Arafah. It was really hot, and imagine from 11 a.m. Until 3 p.m. the heat.
What was the temperature?
The temperature, maybe to me, I believe it was more than 40.
It's really hot.
And you know, you are talking about how many million people in the same place.
Yes.
And there is no place for you to go. And even the tents, we got this one, you know, the camping one. It's still inside hot. Blast, because it's plastic, right? So it's still hot. Yo, Allah. And there is no food.
No food,
no
what
water.
What did you bring with you?
What to bring? Dude, you already carrying your luggage, carry your bag, you know. You thought once you reach there, you know, you'll find a car to sleep under, or you go into the tent.
But what did they do?
There's people sleeping under the cars.
Is it?
There's some families, they used to bring their own car and they sleep inside the car. It's really hot. It's
million
really hot.
People,
To me, there is once, I remember, I don't recall the timing exactly, but they mentioned officially in the Saudi television, that is almost 5 million people performing Hajj that year
at one time.
Yeah, it's normal.
Kita nak tempuh itu baru dekat Arafah tu. Tu yang selalu kalau ustaz-ustaz cerita dia bandingkan dengan pada mahsyar kan.
Kalau dekat Arafah macam tu kan,
those people who's that we call it like the backpackers, like who is backpackers, those who's like, you know, they travel, we did that things, mm-hmm. and it was really tough experience, mm-hmm. like because, but it was fun, mm-hmm. it was fun, it was tough because number one you are relying on yourself, mm-hmm. on your own, mm-hmm. The distance between Arafah and Muzdalifah is not near, mm-hmm. it's quite far, mm-hmm. and also we try to walk from Mina to Makkah, mm-hmm. 5 kilos.
5 kilos, eh?
We walk. So imagine our mukhayyam was way behind, uh-huh. and so we have to go, we throw the jamra, and you know, the fight in jamra, people pushing each other and all this, you know. Mm-hmm. After that we walk. Mm-hmm. So like it was really tough but fun. But the toughest time when I was kid. Mm, because I know nothing.
So for you, how are you going to face the toughest times during performing Hajj after this, you share with us, to counter the, you know, the behavior like tak boleh nak sabar, cannot be patient and everything.
That is the bad part. Mm-hmm. Actually, like we are, once you are going for Hajj, you are looking for forgiveness from Allah Subhanahu Wa Taala, mm-hmm. and you are there to obey Him, mm-hmm. and to try to be a better person. That's why we go to Hajj. Mm-hmm. But there's some people, unfortunately, they take these things as challenge, body challenge.
Challenge, eh?
Body challenge. Wow. You kick me, I kick you. These people are like that, you know, you push me, I push you. These people that are not sabah. And they don't know, like, you know, Tawaf is a sharing place.
Yes, yes.
Mm. Mina is a sharing place. Yeah. Arafah is a sharing place. You have, if, like, you can give a half centimeter for a brother of you, Muslim brother or Muslim sister to sit or to pray, you better do. Because you are there to ask forgiveness and to be a better person.
Mashallah.
Yeah, not to go and fight.
Faham. So it's better for you to be like that rather than you berebut untuk for ibadah, you know, isn't it?
Yes, of course. Because ibadah never come with force. Ibadah come with willingness and with patience and with good faith. because Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala, if once we look into all our ibadah, mm-hmm. all our ibadah is a calm ibadah.
Mm. Calm ibadah.
Salah is a calm ibadah, mm-hmm. istighfar, whatever you do. Mm-hmm. It's just a peacefulness.
Mm-hmm. See,
and you be connected to Almighty.
Yes, yes.
You are not connected to your friend.
Mm-hmm. Okay, Ahmad. What's
the... I drive my car because before also the speed limit was open.
Okay.
So I drive top speed. Uh-huh. I go to Makkah like 3 hours and a half. Mm-hmm. I do my Umrah. I play Subuh. I come back. But before my dad notice I'm not at home.
Semata-mata nama Umrah.
Because I take his car.
So Ahmad, okay, you know, what's the difference between Umrah and Hajj?
Like, of course, Umrah, like, you know, you are doing your Tawaf and you are doing your Sa'i, uh-huh. and you cut your hair, that's it.
Oh, but it's very simple. Yeah,
Hajj, you have to go through, even the Niyyah also is different. But Hajj is, what you call this one? Hajj, you have to be in Arafah, you have to go to Arafah, you have to go to Mina, Muzdalifah, you have to do your Mabit.
What's that?
Mabit in Mina as well.
Okay.
Yeah, and also it depends on like whether you are mufrid or muqrin or mutamatti'.
Yeah,
because muqrin and mutamatti', you have to slaughter dam.
Oh, dam, yeah, bayar dam.
But if you are ifrat, tak bayar.
Tak bayar. Banyak nak kena belajar.
Yelah.
Dia
this one based on my knowledge, huh? I'm not a ustaz. I'm trying to be just to gain knowledge for myself.
So must be every year you celebrate Aidil Adha in Makkah or Madinah?
Me myself, mm-hmm. before, of course, in my hometown, Madinah.
Madinah.
So ada nak tahu beza?
Apa beza? We know that you're from Madinah.
Yes.
So almost 20 years celebrate Aidil Adha in Madinah, isn't it?
Yes.
Madinah, Mekah. Yes. So what's the difference when you move to Malaysia? The difference between celebrating Aidil Adha?
A lot.
Share with us.
The prayers time. We pray like when the sun rise already, we can pray. Here around 8 something, right?
Yes.
Okay, this is one. After the timing.
Sunrise.
Uh-huh. I remember the first time I wanted to pray Eid al-Adha.
Uh-huh.
After Subah prayers, I'm already waiting in the masjid. Waiting. Tak ada ramai datang. I say, maybe Malaysia don't pray Eid Raya.
Okay.
So, when I went back, my friend tell me, hey, you,
they are praying around 8:15. I say, I was doing after Subah prayers, waiting, no one is coming to pray. So okay, the timing is different.
Okay.
Second is about the way we perform the ibadah. For us, we just send the cows and the sheep and the lumbu, you call it, to the slaughtering area. Mm-hmm. But for him, mostly people do it at home or do it within the jama'ah itself. Yes, okay. Yes, and for us there, camels or goats.
Camels or goats.
Here, mostly lumbu.
Lumbu,
Like, you know, I was the first time I was shocked. A lot of lumbus, yeah. What is happening, you know? And those lumbus with big head, you know. Big head. I was really saying, what is happening? You know, I didn't notice. And that one is like, actually is for Raya. I thought someone want to sell.
Oh!
You know, big glories, you know, a lot of lumbu inside. Yeah. I was passing by in PJ there. I look, what's this happening? Like, I said, okay, never mind. Maybe business someone want to sell.
Yeah,
my friend tell me, hey, you, this one is for Raya Haji Qurban. I said, okay.
But something is happening during Hari Raya Aidilaha. You know, the cow will use the highway in Malaysia to run the jatuh pada lori dan lari
I saw. Not I saw, but like, you know, like, sometimes like, you see a lot of people waiting in the same area, in the kampung. Mm-hmm. What happy? What lombu lari. Like, you know, like, they are running, you know. I remember I have a friend of mine from Sabah Benam. He said, the lumbu lari. 1 hour they are looking. He say, imagine all the orang kampung laring around with the knife in the hand. He said, you see him coming, you think he's coming to you, but he's looking for the lumbu.
Macam-macam kita Malaysia. Tapi itulah, itu yang best tu bila kita dapat tahu dekat Madinah, gaya haji dia macam dia kan. Lepas subuh dah solat Aidilaha. Dekat Malaysia ni lambat sikit kan.
So kita nak tanya balik lah ni, kita balik kepada
Haji Fahad yang dia nak kongsikan dengan kita tentang Hajj ni. The manfaat.
Okay, actually the benefits of going to Hajj. Number one, you are performing the rukun of Islam, which is performing your ibadah, which is Hajj. Another, to me, like, you are being close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Like, you know, Hajj doesn't mean that we need to go to Hajj once we are in old age. Actually, we should use the strength of our
physical,
especially in this age. You know, we're still young, we're still strong to go. So we have to go and show this. We appreciate this health we have, and we go and perform our ibadah. Hajj is number, as I tell you, make us close to Allah, make us perform our rukun. Is make us understand that there is no difference between us. We are all the same, whether you are white or black, whether you are a Malaysian or you are not a from Saudi, wherever you are, we are the same, and we are there for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And we all seeking His forgiveness.
Yes.
Whether you are rich, whether you are poor,
yeah,
still, without Allah, you are nothing. Yeah. And also, is to me, is always a sign of showing you that we are not living in this earth alone. Because Arafah is a sharing place. Heaven is a sharing place. Wa na'uzu billah, Jahannam is a sharing place as well. So everywhere is a sharing place. So we need to understand, and we need to know that you are not belong to this place alone.
Yeah. We're sharing.
We are equal.
Equal.
We are equal. Mm-hmm. That's why when you pray, we are pray side by side.
Mm-hmm.
When you go to place, we do things side by side.
Mm-hmm.
So that shows us our life is based on side by side. Mm-hmm. So we have to take life in a way which is we appreciate one another to be a better ummah and better human being.
Insya Allah.
Baik, baik pergunungan ya. Baik, Alhamdulillah. Tidak habis dah.